Hi, I'm Cheeky Chase and welcome to my channel. And in this tutorial I'm going to show you step by step how to make a koi painting from beginning to end. So if you want to paint along, hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss out on part 2 of this tutorial. In this video I'm going to show you the tips and techniques that I use, all the mistakes that I make, because let's face it, we all make mistakes, but more importantly how to fix your mistakes. I will show you what I'm using, when I'm using it. For a full list of what I'm using in this video, check out the description below. In this video, there will be some time lapses. That's just to reduce the length of the watch time, as I paint very slowly, and watching me paint very slowly will be very boring. So grab your brush, grab a cup of tea, and let's get painting. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our round canvas and I'm going to draw out my rocks where I want them placed before we start mixing our paint. So we're just going to quickly draw in where we want them. I'm just using a HB pencil and pressing very lightly. I don't want thick lines because I don't want them to interact too much with the paint. You just want to fill your entire canvas with rocks. Now this is going to be the boring part of the picture, is painting in all these rocks. Now when you put your paint on it, don't put it on really, really thick, because what we're going to have is we're going to have our fish going over the top. So if you put on big, thick rocks, and when you paint a fish over the top, you're going to get that edge showing through on the fish. So what we want is a light paint just to cover the rock. So you want to cover the canvas all the way in the colors, but smooth it out. Don't leave it rough. Colors I'll be using for the rocks are Payne's Grey, Titanium White, and Mars Black. This is System 3. I don't really know anything about this paint apart from it's in my box, so I use it. I've already poured it out, just little bits. I'm using a Stay Wet palette. If you don't know what a Stay Wet palette is, it's just a palette that has a little piece of card behind it which you wet, and you put the piece of paper over the top and it keeps it nice and wet. It comes with a lid so you can keep it closed. As long as there's enough water in there, your paint will stay wet. I've left the paint in this palette for over a week and it's still been wet. So it's a good palette to use if you're worried about your paint and your palette's drying out. So that's Mars Black, the Payne's Grey, Titanium White, and over here you'll see this little blob. This is Golden Mediums Regular Gel Semi-Gloss. I'm going to use this, which will help with the blending. I'm going to mix a little bit of this into each of my color mixes, and I think that's the correct word, but who knows. And it should help with the blending because it will slow down your drying time. Because as you know, even though the Stay Wet palette stays wet, the canvas will dry like within minutes. So when you put your paint down, we're going to need to blend it to get the rocks in a 3D shape. So to help with the blending, I put that on so it should stay nice and moist. To keep the top of my paint wet, my Stay Wet palette, I use a little spray bottle, which just sprays, as you can see. You can also spray this on your canvas if your canvas dries out too fast, like if you live in a hot, hot country. It does improve the flow of your paint because it's a bit wet, There's a lamp behind the canvas. Okay, so let's get in. So with these colors, all you're gonna do, I'm gonna take my brush. So I'm gonna start off with a gray, because I'm gonna leave the darker colors for last. And a bit of white, and a little bit of medium. And then I'm just gonna mix them all together. This is a pretty dark grey, so what I'm going to do, take a bit more white, put a bit of white over there, bit of the same colour, mix it in, I have a lighter grey. Now, I think this is probably the lightest I want to go with the grey. I might actually go a little lighter, I'm not sure, let me just try a little bit. Okay, so there's another one here. So that's a good light grey. And then a darker grey. My shadows. And you can paint your colour, your rocks, in any colour you want. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint all my rocks in grey, and then at the end of this video, or at the end of this series, I'm going to glaze them with oil paint. So that's when I'll change the colour a bit so that it's not just plain grey. I'll add some blues and greens into it. Okay, so there you have it. There's my four main colors I'll probably be using. This darker pieces will be for the in-betweens. Okay, so let's get started. So I'm going to paint one rock for you, show you how I'm doing it, and then I will just clean my brush because it's got loads of color on it. So tissue, just wipe off the excess of your paint because there's just way too much paint on that. And there's also quite a bit of gel medium in that. Okay, so I'm going to paint one rock and then I'll go into a time lapse and then you can follow ahead. So with the rocks, you do your outside darker because my light source, this is looking down on the pond. So my light source is coming from above. So I'm going to have the shadow of my rock, a little water. If your paint isn't spreading very well, add a bit of water, just a little bit, and it'll help spread. So just, forgot what I was saying. So outline the entire rock with your dark. Now this gel that I'm using to extend the life of the paint will dry a little glossy. It's not a problem because at the end of the series we'll varnish the entire painting anyway, so then it will all match because we won't use the gloss for everything in all the colors that we use, especially when we come to paint the fish. But once we varnish it all, it'll take all of the painting and make it all completely nice and glossy and shiny, and it really makes your colors pop. Okay, now I'm moving on to my next gray, my lighter gray. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to blend it in to the dark. It looks like I'm going over it and getting rid of it, but I'm not, because it's leaving a nice dark outer rim, which will give it the 3D effect. And just mix it in, nice backwards and forward strokes. Keep the paint as smooth on the canvas as possible, no lumps. this is coming up on camera. It looks like. And I'm going to my third color. Mix it in. Obviously you don't need as much paint because, again, now your rock doesn't have to be absolutely perfectly blended because the rocks will have different sizes. So at the edges here, gently, move your brush over gently. As you can see with my hand, I'm going very gently, so there's hardly any paint coming off. So gently blend it in. You don't have to have perfect symmetric because rocks are all different shapes. And they'll have different height peaks and everything. So it doesn't really matter if this part is a little lighter because it just adds to the effect. Now I'm on my lightest of my grays. This will be the highest point of my rock. And as you see, I haven't cleaned my brush at all. I'm just using the same brush and just dipping into the colors. Okay, so there is the lightest part of my rock. I'm just gently brushing in these colors all the way around. Gently mixing it. See, there's a little bit streaks of white on top. You can leave them because it will just add to the effect. Okay. So there's a nice smooth rock. If you would like a rough textured rock, take a piece of tissue . Add some white on it, or grey. White will be better because it will stand out more. Because I haven't washed my brush, it's going to be a very light grey. So crush up some tissue. Now what you can do is you can just dab it. Turn your tissue around. Turn your tissue around and around so that you don't get the same shape. So twist it. Twist it all the way around and you get different shapes. And just wipe my brush and then brush away the lumps. I don't want these lumps showing through when I paint my fish. If you want, you can use a soft brush, which is a round mop brush. This is half, and just rub it over the top. Take off all the peaks. So you can have a nice smooth rock or you can have a nice rough rock. It's entirely up to you. I've gone for a bit of a rough rock. On with the mop brushes as you get a lot of hairs. Okay, there we have it. And this is practically dry. This is how fast acrylic dries. Now there are no lumps, so when I paint my fish, it's not going to affect the texture of my fish. So, there you have one rock. Paint on all your rocks, and I will slow down the video once I reach the insides and I'll show you what we're going to do. Thank you. Okay, what you're going to do over here is when you get to a different rock, which is right next to one rock. This rock is above that rock. You can see because it goes over that rock. So what you're going to do is you're going to put it a little bit darker at the edge. Just so that it separates them and it'll be its shadow. You just blend it in like you did the rest. There we go. Okay, so this regular gel semi-gloss medium is making the paint too sticky. I may have put too much in, I'm not sure, but I've decided not to use this. I've thrown away the palette that I had and I'm going to use this one instead, which is a slow drying medium. This one is clear, as you can see, it's clear. Right, nice and shiny, and it's not as sticky. So I'm going to try this one with mixing it with the paints and see how I get on, because I'm not getting very sharp edges, which is what I wanted, sharp edges. It's not a problem because I can fix it. So we'll see. Let's carry on then. That's much better. You can see I'm getting a nice smooth edge, not such a rough one anymore. So yeah, so that is much better. So use the slow drying medium instead. You'll get a better result. This is the boring part of the painting, because you're doing the same thing over and over again. But the good thing is it gets better. Once we move on to the fish, it'll be a lot more fun. Oh yeah, look at that. Look how that mixes. Much better. Paint stays really wet, which means we'll need to wait a bit before we do our little white spots on top. What you see me doing here is I'm just mixing the white straight onto it. Because it's still wet, I can mix the paint directly on the canvas. As you can see, that the paint is staying wet a lot longer, which means my blending on the canvas is proving a little harder than it did before, because it's not drying as fast, so it's very, very wet. So in order to get a good blend, I'm having to use the mop brush. So we're just changing the technique a little bit. So we're applying the paint with this brush. I have no idea what this brush is. Oh, there we go. It's an angle brush. Small angle brush, number 12. Just applying it with this brush. And then once we've got our color down, using a mop brush, just in a little, very, very gently, very, very light, just so you're barely touching. Very gently, just little, little circles around. If you push too hard, you'll remove the paint. Rub off the excess. And see, this is still wet. Gosh, that's good stuff. Okay, so the rocks are painted in. As you can see, I've done different colors. The rocks at the back are darker and the rocks at the front are lighter, which will give you your depth perception. I've put bits of texture on all of them. As you can see, on the darker rocks, I've done less, not as bright as on the top rocks, because these are obviously closer, you're gonna see them more. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill in all the little gaps in black. Now they're technically still rocks, but you can't see them. So it's just going into the shadows there. And then once we've done that, then we've completed the rocks and we'll move on to the next step. This is a filibert number 2 that I'm using. So I wanted my picture to fit the round canvas. I didn't want to ruin my rocks by drawing over them, having to try and remove the pencil lines. So I went on my surface and I drew in Clip Studio Paint, which is my art program. I drew out my fish exactly where I wanted, in a circle, so that it will fit my canvas perfectly. I then projected it onto my canvas, lined up the circle with the canvas, and then just sketched it out. You can get this projector from Amazon, which is only £54. If you don't have a projector, you can sketch it on yourself by freehand, or you can trace it out onto a piece of paper, chalk up the back of the paper, and then retrace it. It will print onto your canvas. Just be careful, because if you rub your hand over the chalk, it will smudge it out, and then you've basically got nothing. Now that my image has been projected onto my canvas, I'm just going to darken the lines, the outside lines of all the fish and the water lilies, just so I can see it better. I'm using a General Scribal all surface pen. It's just a black pencil. Thank you. Now you're probably wondering why I want to cover up all the rocks I painted, and why did I paint the rocks first and not the last. The reason for that is, can you imagine trying to paint these rocks in between all these fish? It's gonna be madness. It will be really hard work to try and get it to look really nice. So that's why I painted the rocks first. That way, I'll paint the fish over. Now, I've not gone in too much detail with my drawing, only because I'm going to fill it in with white. So the detail will come with the paint. Now I can see them a bit better. I am going to use a different titanium white today. I'm going to use golden titanium white, series 1. And this one is quite an expensive one, but it should cover all the darkness behind so that the fish stand out. I've cleaned my palette because I made such a mess on the last one for the rocks. So I'm just going to take a little bit, put it out. I'm not going to use too much because I don't want to waste it. And in my spray bottle, I have added a few drops of Flow Improver. Now this will help the paint go over the canvas a lot easier. So it won't be so thick, it'll help water it down a little. Just spray it a little bit. For the outline of the fish, I'm going to use the Filbert number 2. It just has this nice tip at the end, and I think I'll be able to get right up to the edges of the line to outline the fish. So what I'm going to do is just take a bit of paint on my brush. Wet my brush first. Bit dry, wipe off the excess water. And start outlining the fish. I'm outlining it first just so that my lines will be neat, because filling it in will be a lot easier. I'm looking at my picture at the same time, just so I don't make a mistake. Try to go right over the black lines so that they're not visible. You know how the fins fan out? Well, don't worry about it right now. What we're going to do is just fill it in, make it like round. We'll add a little bit of a flick to it later, but when we go over it with oils, it will be a lot better. As you can see, my pencil is mixing with the white and making a little bit of a grey. It's fine, because this is just a base coat. This is just to cover up most of it. Okay, that's fine. I'm just checking here with my rubber to see if I can take off this black pencil, and it comes off really nicely without affecting the paint. So if you don't get all your lines covered, don't worry about it. We can rub it out afterwards. So as you can see, now I've outlined this fish. Oh, there's a fin I missed when I was drawing. Just noticed it. So I'll just free paint it in. You see it goes out and comes down there. Okay. So the fish is outlined, and now what I'm going to do is go for a little larger brush. It's not very soft, I'm a softer one. Okay, that one. Which is the flat brush number 4. And I'm just going to spray my paint a little bit more because this paint is quite thick. Just to improve the flow a little bit. And I'm going to fill in the rest of the fish. Now remember, this is just a base coat. It doesn't have to be perfectly white. All we're doing is covering up all the gray behind. This black pencil is really mixing with the paint. It's making a grey. You can use a white pencil. I do have one. I have a white pencil, which is for writes on glass, metal, plastic, wood, water soluble. And you know what? I tried to draw with it, and it wasn't very clear. You know, you can see it, but it wasn't as clear as I needed because I don't want to be able to go like, oh, I can't see it once I'm finished with my print. It's got paint all over my hand. So I chose the black one, which is fine because it doesn't matter because it's just mixing with the base coat. I'm just leaving a very slight grey over here, as you can see, just so I know when I come to paint where the tail goes and where the back fin is. Whereas, because if you make it all white, you might get a little bit confused. So, go ahead and fill in all your fish and your water lilies, and we'll meet back here after the time lapse. Okay, there's one thing you need to be careful with, as I've noticed, is the back of my hand is getting all dirty. That's because I'm sticking my hand in my wet palette, so I'm picking up water, and then I'm touching the pencil. And then I've noticed, because I'm smudging there, I'm getting nice smudges. So just be careful with that. That's all my fish and water lilies filled in. As you can see, there's been a lot of basically cross-contamination from the pencil and the paint, but I use that to my advantage. As you can see, I've done a bit of shading just so that I know where this fin goes, where that fin goes. Like here, this one's very confusing because you have the back fin going over the fish, you have the side anal fin coming out the side there, and you have the tail coming up in different directions. So it was a bit confusing to see, because if you just paint this all white, it's just going to be like a blob. And then you have to really think, where is that fin coming from? So I've used the shading from the pencil and the paint, which is not bad. That's the end of part one. I hope you liked it and I hope you learned something. Give a thumbs up if you have. If you haven't already subscribed, then hit that beautiful red button so that you don't miss part two. If you're painting along, I would love to see your progress. So head over to Instagram and post a picture with the hashtag CheekyKoiPaint. If your settings are on private and I won't be able to see your picture with the hashtag, send me a direct message at CheekyChase. Thanks for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you in part two.